Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge. And today in this video, we will learn how to integrate Spring Batch in Spring Boot application. And we'll also discuss what is Spring Batch. Spring Batch is an open source framework that is used for batch processing. And it also provides more advanced technical service and feature that will enable externally high volume and high performance batch jobs through optimization and performance techniques. And why we need Spring Batch? If we want to do complex calculation on large amount of data, then you need a batch processing system. And these are the main use cases of Spring Batch. First one is extract transform load, that is ETL. And ETLs are common in integration scenario. For example, an application may periodically generate files with data that needs to be loaded, transformed, and persisted into the another application's database. So in this video, we will do perform this example. We will read the data from files and then we will store data into database. And the second use case is data migration. Most companies have legacy system, and when adopting a new system, companies have to migrate legacy data to a database compatible with the new system. So this is where Spring Batch shines with its reading, writing, and processing components. And third one is parallel processing. So there are scenarios where simply processing a single operation faster is not sufficient due to the large volume of data. And the only way to optimize time is by processing more operation in parallel. So they require a robust transactional control and failure recovery mechanism, which are complex to implement but quickly. Luckily, Spring Batch has taken care of that. And this is the architecture of Spring Batch. So if we want to integrate Spring Batch in our Spring Boot application, then we need to trigger job launcher, and we also need to create one job and also need to create steps, and each step contain three items, that is item reader, item processor, and item writer. And we can create multiple steps, but for each step the item reader, item processor, and item writer will be separate, so we can perform parallel processing. That is the parallel processing. So today in this video, I will create one Spring Boot project with Spring Batch, and we will read the CSV file and write this CSV file into database, that will be S2 database. And we will use item reader to read the data from CSV file, and then we will process the data by using item processor, and then we will write the data into database using item writer. So okay, let's get started to create one Spring Boot project. So here I will type start.spring.io. So here we need to select project type is Maven project, and language is Java, and Spring Boot version 2.3.4. And here we need to define artifact ID. So here I will type Spring Batch example. And next, what we need to do, we need to add dependencies. So here I will add dependency Spring Batch, and the another dependency that we need to add is Spring Web, that is Spring Web. And the next one is we need to add H2 database dependency, and after that we will add dev tools. So if we will perform any changes in our code, it will automatically loads by JVM. And the next one is JPA repository we will use. So I will add here Spring Data JPA. And next I will add Lombok. So no need to write any setter getter method. So here we can see we have added 6 dependencies. First one is Spring Batch, Spring Web, H2 database, Spring Dev Tools, Spring Data JPA, and Lombok. Click on generate. Now just go to Eclipse and import this project. Click on import existing Maven project. and click on finish. And here we can see we have imported Spring Batch Example project. So what we need to do in this video, we will create one user.csv file and we will read this file using item reader. So what we will do, first I will create one file, that is users.csv. And in this file I will write some data. So just click open with and text editor. So just paste data here, that is column name, ID, name, department and salary. And these are the value: ID 1, name current, department CHD, salary 1000, and secondary code 2, Arjun, Hyderabad 2000. So like this I have added 5 records, and these are the header: ID, name, department and salary. Now what we need to do, now I need to create one model class that will map these all properties into Pojo class. So here I will create one model, new package, and package will be dot model, and inside model class I will create one class, that is user. And user class will contain all the properties that we have defined in our user.csv file. So here I will use @entity, and also you need to define @data. So no need to write any setter getter. @all arg constructor. Persistence, and here we need to use @knower constructor, and here we will define @id for primary key, and it will be private integer id, private string name, private string department, private integer salary, and the next one is current timestamp, private date timestamp. So here we have defined these 5 properties, that for these 4 properties that we have defined in our user.csv file: ID, name, department and salary. So this will map with our Pojo class. And the next we need to create our repository class so that we can write data into database. So here we need to create one more package, and inside this package we will create user repository class. So here the package name will be repository, and the class name will be user repository, and this will be interface. So this will be interface, and this interface will extends JP repository, and our model class is user. And the data type that we have used for primary key is integer. So here we can see we have created user repository. So now after creating this, now we need to create batch specific properties. So here what we will do, we will create one more package, and inside this package we will create one config class. Example dot config, and here we will create spring batch config. And at this class level, we will use annotation, that is @configuration. So Spring will understand and will create the bean for this class also. And we also need to enable our batch processing. Enable batch processing. So here what we need to do, first here we need to create one job, and then we will create step, and after that we will create item reader, item processor and item writer. So to need to create a job here, first here I will define the bean, and here I will create one function that is public job, and here we need to inject and use a job builder factory will be used to create the job, and also what we need to do here, we need to use step builder factory also, so that we can create step also. Factory, and what we need to do more, we also need to create item reader, processor and writer. So item reader and model class is user. Item reader and item processor user, item processor, and next thing is item writer, and model is user, and item writer, okay. So here we will use job builder factory to create the job. So here I will just create job builder factory dot get. So here we need to define the name for our job, that will be etl job. And after defining the job name, what we need to do, we need to define incrementer. So what is incrementer? Here we can define our own customized incrementer, but here I am just using predefined incrementer, that is run id incrementer. So if we want to create our own incrementer, then we need to implement job parameters incrementer, that is we need to implement at our own class if we want to create our own customized incrementer. So here we are just using predefined incrementer. And next, what we need to define the steps. So here we will call start function, and if we want to define only single step, then we can use start function. If we have multiple steps, then we need to use flow. So here we need to just define one step. So what I will do here I will create step is equal to null. I will cut from here and just paste it here, and inject batch dot core step. So what need to do here, now I will build this, and after build what we need to do here, we also need to define assign statement to local variable, and that will be job, and from here we need to return job. Okay, and the next thing, after creating the job, now we need to create step. So here we will use step builder factory to create the step dot get, and here we need to define the name for step, so that will be etl step. And after that what we need to define chunk. So here I need to process in chunks is nothing but just batching. So here I will define the size for chunk. If I want to process 100 records at a time, then we need to define chunk size is 100. And here we need to define our model class, that is user user. And next, what we need to do here, we need to define also create reader, writer and processor. So first I will define reader, and here item reader, and the next is processor, and item processor, and the next one is writer, and here the name is item writer, and the next one is build. So here we have created step. So here we have defined all the configuration that is required for our Spring Batch application. And here I have already annotated @ configuration annotation and @ enable batch processing annotation at class level, so that Spring Boot can by default trigger and scan this particular class file and load all the configurations from this file. And one more thing I need to do is I need to disable the Spring Batch job trigger by default. So what happens is by default Spring Boot job will enable. So what we need to do here, we need to go to application.properties file and we need to disable Spring Boot default batch processing. So here I will just paste it, and here I have defined spring.batch job enabled is false. If we do not add this property, then Spring will by default to use the simple job launcher and automatically start it based on the configurations. And which we are going to add here, so that is what we are doing here. We are just disabling that particular default configuration, and where we have already created one job. So here we can see the job that we have already created. So now we will use this job. Now here we can see our job is ready, but now we need to provide implementation for item reader, item processor and item writer. Okay, let's start with reader. First we need to read the CSV file. There is an inbuilt function or class that called is flat file item reader. So we are going to leverage that in order to read this file. So we are going to use flat file item reader. So here I will create one more function and will create the bean for item reader. So here what I will do, here I will just create one more bean, that is public flat file item reader. I will use here, and user is the model class that we are using, and flat item reader. So I will use, so here we need to change it, here we need to use flat file item reader and user. So here we need to define the function name, that is item reader. So this bean will created from here, and here we need to use @ value annotation, and we just need to define the path of file. And here input variable that it will read from application.property file. So resource will get all the data and configurations, and import this package code.io.resource. Now I will go to my application.properties file, and here we need to copy the path for our user.csv file. Just go here and go to properties and copy this path. Now go to our application.properties and just paste this path here and use double backslash. Okay. Now I will go to Spring Batch Config class, and here now resource will get this particular file, that is user.csv file, and now we need to use this file. So here I will use flat file item reader and user flat file item reader is equal to new flat file item reader. And what we need to do here, now I will assign the resource first. So flat file item reader dot set resource, and here I will set resource. And next, now we need to set some default value that we will be required for particular item reader. So here I will use flat file item reader, and here I will use dot set name. So here I will just need to define the name, CSV reader we can define, and this is a default value that we need to use some few values. And now we need to set the number of lines that you want to skip. So I just want to skip header files, header column names. So here I will use set lines to skip, and here I will just pass the value 1, so it will skip first line of our user.csv file. And after that, so we need to use line mapper, and we also need to map our user.csv file into our Pojo class. So now we need to map data with user Pojo. So here I will use flat file reader dot set line mapper that will be used to map our CSV file into user model. And here I will just create one function line mapper, and here I will return flat file item reader. Now what I need to do here, I just need to create one more function, create method. So now I will go here, and here we need to create the bean. So the function will be public, and here I will use the annotation that is @bean. And the next, we need to create default line mapper. So here I will create default line mapper, line mapper that is user. And as we know, our CSV file data is comma separated, so we need to use tokenizer. So here I will use delimited line tokenizer. Tokenizer that is equal to new delimiter tokenizer. And now we need to provide name of the columns. So here I will use line tokenizer dot set names, and here I will just create one string of array, and in this array we will need to define the name of header columns, that is ID, and the second is name, and third one was department, and fourth was salary. And after defining the names of column, now we need to set each field into our user Pojo class. So what I will do here, we will use bean wrapper that will be used to wrapper field set mapper class that will be used to map our all properties file value that is user.csv into our Pojo class. So here I will define field set mapper इज इक्वल टू न्यू डिफॉल्ट न्यू बीन रैपर एंड व्हाट वी नीड टू डू नाउ आई विल जस्ट सेट द टारगेट टाइप फील्ड सेट मैपर डॉट सेट टारगेट टाइप इन विच मॉडल वी वॉन्ट टू सेट सो हेयर वी जस्ट वॉन्ट टू सेट इन टू यूजर डॉट क्लास एंड नाउ वी नीड टू सेट दिस फील्ड सेट मैपर इन टू आवर डिफॉल्ट लाइन सो हेयर आई विल यूज डिफॉल्ट लाइन मैपर डिफॉल्ट लाइन मैपर So here we have just defined the name is line mapper dot set tokenizer. First we will set tokenizer and that is line tokenizer. Now I will set line mapper dot set field set mapper. And here we need to pass field set mapper as a property value. Now here what we will return. Here I will just return line mapper. So that we have done, we have created our item reader. Now we can say our item reader is ready. Now we need to create item processor. Because after creating item reader, what we need to create item processor and item writer. So first we will create item processor. So here I will create one more package. That is processor example dot processor and here the class name will be processor so this class will implement item processor so this class will implement item processor interface from batch item and our model is user and model user and here we need to add unimplemented methods and this is the process function here we can perform any type of processing with our object so here I will just set user dot set and here I will change the name user dot set timestamp So here I will just set the current time, new date, and here I will return user. So what we need to do now? Here I will just define the annotation that is @component. So bean will be created. Now what we need to do after creating item processor? We need to create item writer. So here I will create one more package. New class and here we need to define the package name writer that is db writer and here we need to implement item writer interface and the model is user So here we will define annotation that is @component and add unimplemented methods and this item writer will be used to write the data into database. So what we will do here? Here if we want to write the data into database then we need to inject user repository into our class so here I will just inject user repository into our class and we'll use the user repository to save the user into database so here what I will do I will save user repository dot save all and users so all users will be saved into database Now one more thing that we need to to add one trigger point. That is nothing but we need to create controller, and in this controller we will create one rest endpoint. So our request will be goes from this rest endpoint, and our batch processing will be start. So here I will just create one class that is user controller, and controller, and the class name is user controller. And here we just need to define the annotation, that is @ rest controller, and in this class we'll create one rest endpoint that will return string send batch request. So here I will just use simple mapping, that is @ get mapping annotation, and we'll define the path to start the job. So here we'll start, and what we need to do first, here we need to launch our job launcher, then job will start, and then our step will execute. So first we will run our job launcher that is provided by Spring Boot. So here autovide will be used to inject job launcher into our class. So here I will use job launcher, and also need to autovide the job that we have created in Spring Batch Config class. In this class we have created one job, so we will inject this job into our user controller. Private job. So that we have done. Now I will just call job launcher run function, then our job will be start. And here we need to pass two parameter, first one is job and second one is job parameters. So what we need to do here, we just need to create one map, and this map will be of string comma job parameter. So here just need to use job parameter util dot map, and here maps is equal to new hash map that we can use, and here maps dot put, and here we need to define the key will be like timestamp, and the value is new job parameter, and here we will pass the parameter system dot current time in millisecond. So that is a function, and save it. And next we need to create job parameters. Is equal to new job parameters, and here we will just pass this map, and we will use and pass it here. And now we need to handle the exception, so here I will just throw keyword using to handle the exception. It will throw different types of exceptions, so I am just using its parent. And here we need to assign the variable, assign statement, so job execution, and from here I will just return one string message, return job execution dot get status. Batch job so this will be the message that we can see Okay, so we have done each and everything. Now we just need to go over application.properties file, and here we have declared database related properties. And now I will run this application. Run as Java application. And here we can see our job has started at port number 8080, and these are the default URL for database access. So now I will go to my browser, and first I will access database, that is localhost 8080 h2 console. So here we can see that is in memory database, and here I have just copied this command and paste it here. And if I will run this command, if I will execute these all queries, so here we can see no records in all tables, no row, no rows, no rows. We have just created only single table, that is user, and all other tables created by default, that is batch job execution context, everything created by default. So now what we need to do here, I will just hit the rest endpoint that we have created, localhost 8080 and start, and here we can see spring batch job failed. So we need to check why it's failed.
Template timestamp and the following status field. So I just need to check my application.properties file, and here we need to check input. So here I just need to define here file, so it will be the file path. Now I will stop it again and rerun this application. Just click on this run as Java application, and everything is looking fine.
So here we can see our job has started. Now our database will be start again. So we will copy it and refresh this one, continue and connect, and we'll hit the all queries. So here we can see no rows in database available. So now I will hit this rest endpoint again. So here we can see spring batch job completed. And now if I will check that record in database, execute all queries. So here we can see the all record that we have defined in user.csv file saved into our database. And here we need to note the time, that is 2143. And below we can see our job executed one time, and batch job execution context is also one, and batch step that we have created, ETL step, is also one time. And here we can also see our job is completed. And now if I will again hit this endpoint, so we will check that time, that 2143 and 12. So here we will see and execute queries again, the time has changed 2144. And next we can check batch job execution, two records are here, two times job executed, and context value is also two times, and step execution also two time. Like this we have completed our spring batch. And these are the Spring Batch architecture. Okay, thanks for watching this video.